Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to Biking Roots to the channel. We're not in Texas today. We are actually in Utah. Can't see the mountains from here yet, but you will. Last couple days, we've been doing a little bit of riding. We actually went to Park City, went on a sweet bike park up at Deer Valley. I didn't do a lot of filming up there, but it was super fun. Little crash with my youngest, but he's okay. Took the Transition Spur. But this morning, I haven't had a chance since we've got here, but today I wanted to ride something with a motor, since there's some climbing involved, and let's be honest, I'm from zero elevation, and we're at like 5,000 feet and up, so lots of elevation, and so I need some help. All right, there's the spur, and here's the Norco Fluid VLT. I talked about this on a different video, so I'll put a link in the description if you want to know more about all the specs and features of it. So I have not ridden this other than the parking lot, so I think I'm all charged up. It's basically, I just took it from the showroom and brought it up to Utah, and now we're gonna go for a ride. And this is the S2 version, so to kind of fit me, my wife, and my oldest son, it's 5'4" to 5'8", so I think the size is gonna be on the little bit smaller but sporty size for me. The other one just felt a little bit too big, so I am excited to give it a try. I have no idea where I'm going. Hey, buddy. Hopefully I don't get a sticker. I did not bring a spare tube, and I forgot to set these up tubeless. Eco mode, a little more effort, but not unmanageable. Look at that. Downtown Salt Lake. Got about 3 miles. I've used up one of my precious battery bars, so I got 4 left. Yeah, I don't know how much I've climbed. Right now I'm in eco mode. Still about 140, 150 beats per minute, so I'm still getting a good workout even in more torqued mode. But this is what e-bike's about. I love my spur, but I couldn't have done it on this. Not with my fitness level, my energy level, and amount of water I'd probably have to bring. Well, that was fun. I'm in the midst of a burnt mountainside from the fires last week. As you can see, I don't know if you can see in the background there, you can see downtown. That's Ensign Peak, I believe. I think I hiked up there with my parents when I was a little kid. And I have to say, I wouldn't have been able to come up here without some electric assistance. I'm not gonna lie. At my age, with my knees and my fitness level, like, yeah, the spur's awesome, but wouldn't have been able to do it without the e-bike. So how's the Fluid VLT doing? Well, so far, awesome. Gone through different modes. It did turn orange here for a little while, and then I couldn't see my riding mode, so I don't know what happened. I turned it off, turned it back on, and it was fine, so I'll have to look what orange means. Hopefully it's not like overheating or it's mad about something. It seems fine. Other than that, shifting hasn't been completely on par, but it is new, so hopefully it's just some chain stretch and not the Shimano Dior, which was one of my gripes why they put Dior on such a nice bike. But other than that, everything feels great, at least going uphill. This is the Bonneville Shortline Trail. Shortline, I believe. So that's gonna go that way. So I don't know where I'm going, but the map shows this way, so let's keep going. All right, I think I have some descending to do. I have a feeling I won't be climbing as much. We'll see. There we go. Whee! Oh, that's cool. Oh, some drift in there. Woohoo! Yeah, it's a sharp turn. Here we go. Yeah. It's loose. Loose over hard. Cool. Into the woods. Squirrels.
sharp turn.
This is fun. I like the change of scenery. Going into the woods. Woo-hoo. Ooh, sharp turn. Oh, yeah.
I will say it's light enough, but still has the power to do what I wanted to today, at least. The fork, the silo is perfectly smooth for the price point. Like, yeah, it might be a little bit heavier than some of the nicer stuff, but it feels great. I didn't even use the lockout at all. Actually, I didn't use it on the shock either. So maybe that would have helped me a little bit on, but I have a motor, so whatever. Drivetrain, yeah, it's probably the weakest point of the bike, like I mentioned earlier. I may change that out to, I don't know, maybe transmission. Transmission would help on those steep climbs. The pharmaceutical tires, Zynitol and the Cryptitol, handled beautifully, especially on that really rocky, loose over hard surface, which it could get a little bit rowdy at times when you're coming down. So yeah, I definitely enjoyed it. So tires held up well. Brakes were fine. I mean, I'm coming off my Lewis brakes, which right now are my favorite. So these slates are okay, a little bit noisy. I don't know, just the dust or the pad type, or maybe I cooked them, who knows. But other than that, pretty well. No other issues to speak of. As far as the fluid itself, the frame, geometry feels great. The size feels great, and this for me being 5'8". Yeah, you could go to a bigger one if you're a little bit taller, but for me it fits perfect. Time to figure out how to get back home and go from there.
Oh, what the coyote? Oh, come on, shifting. Ooh, it's steep. Ooh. High Street Bike Park. Pedal bikes only, no e-bikes.
All right, well, looks like I have to stop here. I'm at Ice Street, kind of like a cool dirt jump part I've heard about, but I don't know a ton about. I guess I didn't do enough research because they don't allow e-bikes here. So I guess still one of the cons of the e-bike, lots of pros, but one of the cons is you're just not allowed everywhere, sorry. Which I get, I don't, you know, they build the trails for jumps and stuff, so I get that they don't want e-bikes here and Surons and, sorry Jared, but no Surons. So I've been off an e-bike for a number of years, as I mentioned on other videos, but the fluid definitely, I think I'm going to have fun on this bike as long as I ride it and own it slash use it, whatever you want to call it. For now, it's mine and I'm using it, but yeah, I can't say enough about it.
All right, e-bike, you are not wanted here. Back you go. Whee! Oh, yeah, I need to settle down. Ooh, that's tight. Ooh. Oh, some drifting. Tight berms. Oh. There we go, that's a little better.
And because I was on an e-bike, I come back in record time to spend time with my boys.
You wish.
That was only like an hour and 20 minutes because of the e-bike, guys. So now I can spend more time. I went on my ride, had a great time.
Darn, why'd you have to come back?
Oh, see, doesn't want to spend time with me. But at least you have the opportunity to possibly spend time with the people you love. All right, well, thanks for watching, guys. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. We'll see you on the next video. Take care. Bye.